Dr. Sonari Mansingh, Honorable Member of Parliament. Sri Manoj Tiwari, Honorable Member of Parliament. Mansi Gulati, author, excellencies, representatives of different countries, and distinguished gathering, sisters and brothers. I am delighted to release the book, Yoga and Mindfulness, which provides a broad and comprehensive overview of yoga and its benefits. This book by Mansi Gulati, a well-known yoga exponent, will further enrich the enormous literature and body of work on yoga. Written in simple language, from a user's perspective, the book will come in handy for the beginners as well as regular yoga practitioners. I would like to compliment Mansi for her untiring efforts in popularizing yoga. Dear sisters and brothers, yoga is an ancient physical, mental, and spiritual discipline. It's an India's gift to the world. We all need to be proud of the fact that the United Nations have declared June 21st as the International Yoga Day, following the efforts of our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Bhai Modi. I would like to recall that Prime Minister has told the UN General Assembly in 2014, he said, "Yoga is an invaluable gift of ancient Indian tradition. It embodies unity of mind and body, thought and action, restraint and fulfillment, harmony between man and nature, and a holistic approach to health and well-being. Yoga is not about exercise, but to discover the sense of oneness within ourselves, the world and nature. By changing our lifestyle and creating consciousness, it can help us to deal with climatic change. Today, around 180 countries are celebrating International Yoga Day on June 21st. As the world leaders have recognized its wide-ranging beneficial effects on mind and body, and its holistic impact on the well-being of an individual. In fact, during my foreign travels, I have noticed that presence of yoga training centers in many countries, including Latin American countries. I also heard from the presidents of some of the countries that they were proudly telling that they had yoga in their parliament. That speaks about the acceptance of yoga around the globe. I would also like to mention that yoga has nothing to do with religion, although some people with bigoted mindset and tunnel vision are attempting to give it a religious color. I want to make it very clear, because we have the high commissioners of different countries and also guests from outside, that yoga, some people are trying to confuse by giving it a communal color. Yoga has no religion. It does not prescribe any religion. Any religious person or irreligious person can practice yoga. After all, it's a discipline of mind and body, bringing both of them together. If mind and body work together, what else you need? So it gives you really perfection. It has no religion. One person told me, "Sir, I have no problem doing yoga, but Surya Namaskara is a problem." I said, "What? Surya Namaskara?" I said, "Don't do Surya Namaskara. Do Chandra Namaskara," I told him. So meaningless. So nature, na, Surya or Chandra, they are not confined to India or this country or the continent or anything. They are universal everywhere. They are nature, part of our nature. So that being the case, why should anybody have any reservation about this? The fact that people in several countries across the continents have embraced yoga shows the hollowness of claims that link yoga to religion. Various studies have chronicled the health-enhancing outcomes of yoga for many medicinal problems, from depression to asthma. The need to make yoga an integral part of the daily routine has become an absolute necessity in the present times to combat lifestyle diseases which have acquired menacing proportions. The lifestyles have changed. That is the basic problem today. Because there is no physical activity. Everybody is living in a closed environment, air conditioned, mind also conditioned, and body not conditioned. And then we are not able to see sun. light. We are not able to enjoy pure water. We are not able to take advantage of the nature in our country. So sometime back I was in London. The driver who was driving my car, he told me, "Sir, good morning. Today is sunny day, happy," he said. I said, "Is it your son's birthday?" He said, "No, sir, sunny day, sunny day." I said, "What is sunny day?" He said, "Sir, sun is very bright today." I said, "Poor fellow, in India 365 days are sunny days." But we never took advantage. Now the thinking has started, the Prime Minister has taken initiative, solar alliance has been formed, and now the government of India has kept 220 gigawatts power generation through solar. So this is very much required. You go to doctor, any one of you go to doctor, including myself, doctor will say there is some deficiency in the body. This vitamin, that vitamin, D3 or something or other. But so that way, you, even if you are rich, you are not taking perfect food. Food includes this also, light also. So we have to expose ourselves to sun. That is an advantage we have in India, but India people also, as I told you. And then physical activity used to be part of our life. Now I always try to convey in a simple, ordinary terms to people. I am not an expert. You are saying Mahapurusha. I am a Purush, not Mahapurush. And I am not an expert in international law. I only studied international law, that's all. But I have 40 years of experience in public life. I have seen the lifestyle of the people. Literally, there is no activity. You get up in the morning from bed, get down, and then no physical activity. Earlier it is to go to toilet, we used to go 1 kilometer. Now I am not suggesting it. Swachh Bharat has come, now it has come. Toilet has come home, we must use it. Earlier we used to bend to go to toilet. Now you have a commode, no physical activity. Then even to take bath, we used to go to bathroom. Now bathroom is inside. Earlier to take bath, we used to bend and take water from the bucket and then put it on our head. Now we have a shower which is coming on your head. Earlier, if somebody calls you from outside, you have to go and then open the door. Even that is not there, now remote is there, door is open automatically. Earlier, even the car, to start a vehicle, it requires some sort of a kick or key or whatever it is. Nothing now, everything is meter. And then earlier to make a telephone call, you used to go to telegraph office. Now the phone has come to your house. Earlier you have to go to a corner to pick up the phone. Now phone has come to your ear and your mouth. There is no activity also. Earlier people used to sit down and eat food. Now you have a dining table. Earlier people used to go to wash hands. Now you have a finger bowl. Literally there is no activity. I am trying to simplify how lifestyle has undergone change. So keeping this in mind, and then the reason is, the effect of it is all diseases are coming to us. All diseases are coming to us because, one, we are not taking advantage of the nature. Second, we are not having any physical activity at all. Earlier in school, we used to have a PT, physical training class, compulsory. Now schools are in multi-storied buildings, apartments. So where is the place to play? So we have to think seriously about all these things. I remember as a student, I used to have a PT class. I used to have a craft class, learning the craft from here. Then we used to have a gardening class, befriending with the nature. That is not there. We have cut down all the gardens successfully. Now we are trying to plant trees also. The result is less greenery means less rains. Less rains means again less greenery. All these things are interlinked. Keeping that in mind, we must go back to lifestyle, traditional lifestyle, do some physical activity. And best thing is yoga. Easiest, simple. And as Prime Minister was saying, yoga is an exercise and activity without cost. For everything else, you have to pay some money. For yoga, you need not pay anything. It can be made, it is being made very simple thanks to the initiative of many people, the yoga teachers. Right from Baba Ravdev, who has popularized it and taken it to many of the houses, and even youngsters like Mansi, they're all making their best efforts to convey the yoga in proper sense to the people. Then another problem coupled with this is lifestyle change, then food also. Food also, Indian food, similarly other foods of other countries, they are linked with seasons. What season, what food, what fruit, what vegetable. That is what we have learned from our civilization. But today, you have instant food. I told the other day, instant food means constant disease. That has to be understood. You can't have instant food. Food has to be cooked properly. It has to be taken care. But that also is not being attended to by people properly. That's why all these problems are coming at very young age. Some of the studies recently indicate about cancer, how it is affecting. Junk food we should not eat. So when you do yoga, automatically all these things, they also follow, they will also guide you properly. So I feel that the need is to make yoga an integral part of the daily routine, as it is absolute necessary in the present times to combat lifestyle diseases which have acquired menacing proportions. According to ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research, India State Level Disease Burden Study Report, the estimated proportion of all deaths due to non-communicable diseases has increased from 37.0% in 1990 to 61.8% in 2016. As per National Family Health Survey, 2015-16, 11% of women, 1 in 10, and 15% of men, 1 in 7, in the 15-49 age group are hypersensitive. It is estimated that number of cancer patients in India is around 2.25 million, and every year over 11.5 lakh new patients are diagnosed with the disease. The estimated number of cancer-related deaths are 2018 is over 7.8 lakhs. These are worrisome statistics, and this unhealthy trend, increased cancer cases has to be curbed by concerted efforts of healthcare professionals, policymakers, and other stakeholders in the health sector. The government has formulated the National Health Policy 2017, which seeks to promote preventive health care and ensure universal access to good quality health care services. In short, the policy seeks to move away from the sick care to wellness with thrust on prevention and health promotion. It basically seeks to reduce the premature mortality from cardiovascular disease, cancer, diabetes, or chronic respiratory disease. Every individual has to become health conscious and avoid leading a sedentary lifestyle, eating junk food, and harmful use of excessive alcohol and tobacco. Obesity also is a common health problem, and I'm sure that integrating yoga into daily routine will help in combating various illnesses. Regular practice of yoga will aid in strengthening muscles, improving respiration, lung functions, metabolism, and circulation. It would also help in improving immune systems and mind relaxation. Another care that has to be taken, maintaining proper health and balance of mind, is not to use cell phone while in meetings. That's part of our culture. It should be part of human culture. The biggest nuisance to mind is the cell phone. And with the advent of, and I'm not saying don't use cell phone, use it whenever necessary. And when you go to any meeting, put it in a silent mode. Otherwise, it will become violent in between and disturb the atmosphere also. And then create irritation to people, other people who do not use that. And also we are using the social media also. Social media should be used to positive messages. You were saying that I'm a positive thinking person. Positiveness gives you longer life. Positiveness gives you fresh ideas. Positiveness gives you good ideas, and then you'll be able to perform better. Because tension means no attention. Tension means no attention to any work. And through yoga, you will have attention. So one boy asked me, sir, what is the advantage of doing yoga? I said, there are many advantages. Nahi, mujhe bataye ek kya? Yoga ke karan se mujhe kya milega? This is the language people are using. Mujhe kya milega? मैंने कहा योगा योगा करने से आप योग्य बनेंगे ऐसे यू विल बी यूजफुल सो दिस इज माय दिस थिंग आई कॉम्प्लीमेंट मानसी गुलाटी फॉर ब्रिंगिंग आउट दिस बुक एंड आई होप पीपल विल गो थ्रू इट आई एम हैप्पी द मिनिस्टर फॉर ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट बिकॉज इज द कंसर्न मिनिस्टर फॉर द एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन अवर कंट्री एंड आई पर्सनली फील दैट योगा शुड बी मेड पार्ट ऑफ our curriculum. basic. Children should be taught from the beginning. Earlier, children used to be taught about life and lifestyle changes and problems by the grandmother and grandfather. Nowadays, forget grandmother and grandfather, even father and mother are not living together with the children. So that being the case, we must have yoga as part of curriculum. I suggest to the government same. And thank you once again, Mansi, God bless you. And I'm thankful to all of you for attending this book release function. After I became vice president, I have realized that vice president releases number of books goes around. And when vice president goes out, you know, there will be traffic regulation, and because of protocol and all problems to people, all these things. So I have decided, I asked my people to construct a good hall here so that you can have functions here. And if you have to go and then hold a meeting in a hall, then hall also is costly in Delhi. So this is no cost, like yoga. like yoga, no cost. And secondly, the vice president need not go out. That also will help in reducing pollution also because of vehicular traffic and all. So this and auditorium, I got it constructed in 3 months through prefabrication. And then named it after the great icon of India, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, the unifier. The unifier of all the 565 samsthanams or provinces of various parts of India, they all were brought together by the great person, Sardar Vallabhai Patel. I am happy that people are making use of this hall in a better manner. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.